Yep. No. All right, you're live.
Hi, everybody. Dr. Robert Cohen, certified plastic surgeon. So I'm really happy that things are shaping up. So the patient's chest was reduced dramatically with a combination of liposuction and then laser tissue removal and then a tightened skin with J plasma, which you probably saw earlier. And now it's the sort of finishing touch. I did put a drain in, which I don't usually do for gynecomastia, but if I'm doing J plasma, I want all that fluid and gas to get off of it and not collect under the skin. So he has a small drain in. As you can see, really small. And what people don't, I want to show you this actually. So, well, I this is all one size. Can you see the so the inside of the brain looks like this. That's the part that's in the body, and this is the part that's outside the body. So, you know, some surgeons use drains that flare out and you try to pull and it hurts. These drains, when you pull them out, they just slide right out. So for all the people who are nervous about drains, if I have to use a drain for some reason, you're not going to have discomfort when it comes out. So anyway, so now I'm just getting the surface skin off the areola, and that's going to make a lot smaller. The next step is going to be the cauterization, which not only stops this tiny little bit of bleeding, which is not much, but it also helps to shrink and contract the skin. That's probably just as important for me for what I want. And then after that, I'm going to do some layers of suturing to put everything back in place.
Well, let's
see, it's a nice shrinkage in one sack here. Question?
Will this leave a scar?
Yeah, so anytime you have an incision, there's always going to be a scar. So there's sort of this kind of misconception that if you're a plastic surgeon, you can do scarless surgery, that if you make a cut on the skin, you're going to have a scar. The key is to make the scar as nice as it can be and also as hidden as it can be. So if you put a scar in a well-hidden location, like for example, he had bigger areolas, now he's got a smaller areola, and the edge of the areola is going to look like the scar is going to come out the edge of the areola. And I don't think it's going to be very noticeable at all. So if you see that shrinkage happening as I'm starting to cauterize this, I'm just going to edge it a little bit more.
Will he have inverted nipples after?
He won't. It looks a little inverted after pulling on it in a weird way, but after I sew this together, I'm going to let go. The nipple is going to stay puckered out, and this is going to get tightened up like that. So it's going to actually look very masculine over here versus the other side, which is oversized and puckered. So you have to keep watching as I'm completing this, but you can see as this starts to come together like that, it creates a little bit of fullness, so it counterbalances that little bit of inversion that you see. So the 3OP this one. So I'm going to start my deep layer closure. Suture here, it keeps tension off the nipple while things are moving. So I want the minimal tension of the skin so it goes to as fine a scar as possible. And that's just the number of circles. As I get each layer, it's going to tighten the bigger circle to the size of the smaller circle. That's the goal. So that this area is small and massive. It's a similar technique that I use for female patients who need a certain amount of mastopexy either because of oversized areolas or the pointy shape of the breast or too much skin or for various reasons. It really just helps to cinch up the breast skin in a way that leaves a very innocuous scar for people who do not want it.
Could you please speak a little bit louder?
Yeah. Just repeat the last thing I said?
Yeah.
Okay. So it said as I'm sewing this, it's creating a little bit of projection. So that's why I had that slight degree of hollowness behind the areola. So now you can see as I'm stitching up, everything is going to look really nice and flush. You don't want this nipple sticking out. You don't want it, the areola, you don't want it sticking out. You don't want it indented. You want it to sort of even with the skin as much as possible. Thank you. patients are cold, they're always pretty happy with how that area looks like. It's when they're warm is when it's the issue. They get looser and puffier. So this patient, I would say, fairly puffy large areolas, which is another more feminine rather than masculine trait. And so guys do not like large puffy areolas. So most women don't either, but particularly guys hate them. So try to do everything possible to make the areola really small or flat.
We have a question. Do you do any contouring, or was it just gyno removal?
No, I mean, if you were watching me earlier, I did a ton of work. So I did liposuction, lipocontouring, I did glandular tissue resection, I did J plasma. So all those maneuvers were contour out the chest as a kind of a combination of techniques, with this being the finishing touch. That's going to create the overall aesthetic that you're shooting for, which is a much flatter, more masculine chest. So it's hard to appreciate once you saw the pre-op photos. I'm sure we'll learn before and afters pretty soon. But he's a very, very significant anagnosia, a very feminine looking chest. It's very bothersome to him. And this is going to be a very masculine looking chest now. He's totally flat. He's going to have a little bit more definition over here and small areola once I get done with all the suturing. Because again, each layer of suturing I do makes the areola smaller and smaller. This is just layer one. So next I'm going to do a deeper layer.
Cool. Those are all the questions.
Okay. Well, stay tuned and watch out in the next few days for hopefully for a before and after video.